Bishop Patrick L. Wooden here, pastor of the Upper Room Church of God in Christ, Bishop of North Carolina Third Jurisdiction, but coming to you today as a concerned, proud African-American citizen of this country, a participant in the political process, and most importantly, a staunch believer in the Word of God. I believe that Jesus Christ is the only Savior. I believe that the Bible is God's love letter to us. And I believe, my friends, that America is the greatest nation on this earth. And I'm glad to be an American. I'm glad to of my African descent. I love my color. I love my gender. I think that when God made me, God got it right. So I am speaking to you about some concerns that I have as a brother, as a citizen, as a person who believes that everyone should participate in the political process, especially those of us of a darker hue, because we didn't get it freely. We had to march for it, we had to fight for it, and we gained the right to vote. And with that right, not just privilege, with that right, I think that we should cast informed and educated votes, and that everyone should participate in the political process. I want to read a passage of scripture to you. The Apostle Paul said this in Romans chapter 9, verse 1 and 2. I say the truth in Christ, I lie not, my conscience bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost, that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I could wish myself accursed from Christ for my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. Here the Apostle Paul makes a racial, not a racist, a racial statement concerning his own Jewish brethren, his Jewish ancestry. And he says that I could, not that he did. In fact, if you study the language, he deals with the impossibility of what could be done. He says, I wish that I could, if I could, I wish that I would be accursed from Christ in order that my Jewish brethren might be saved. And he gives a list of privileges that was given to the Jews. And what he was bemoaning was their spiritual state and how that they had missed what God was doing in Christ Jesus. Well, my friends, I on a much lesser level, if you will, bemoan some of the things that I've seen, especially when it comes to arguments that are made with regards to African Americans. I want to say to you on the onset of this, I am a registered non-affiliate. I once was a Democrat. I've never been a registered Republican. I am a registered non-affiliate. Neither party have their hands in my pocket. And when I vote issues. I do not vote party. I do not vote skin color. I do not vote gender. I vote issues. And I vote for any politician whose positions agree with mine. I don't shift my positions to agree with theirs. If they agree with my sincerely held religious beliefs, hey, you got my vote. If you do not, then you won't get my vote and you won't get my support. Also, as a Christian minister who pastors a church, which is a 501c3, we're not allowed in church to endorse any political candidate, and we haven't. We are, however, allowed to talk about positions. We are allowed to talk about policies. We are allowed to agree with any candidate on any position that agrees with us. But you can't then say, because I agree with candidate XYZ, then you should vote for that candidate, or you shouldn't vote for the other candidate. Now, have I said, as a Christian, I cannot support this view or that view, or I don't see how, as a Christian, you could support a view? not a candidate, a view that a candidate may have that is opposite, that is antithetical to biblical teachings? Yes, I have, and will continue to do so, because I do not agree with those who have said to me, Bishop Wooden, you should separate your religion from your politics. The last time I checked, the God of the Bible says, not in some, but in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. So all is inclusive of everything, so it certainly means politics also. So with this disclosure, you can imagine how I must have felt when I saw a sign and read the story of a wonderful church. I know nothing negative about this church. I know nothing negative about the pastor. And if I did, I wouldn't say it to you. But there is a church in Alabama. The name of the church is New Era Baptist Church. All of this is public. And there's a sign in front of the church that says a black vote for Trump is mental illness. And the other side of the sign reads a white vote for Trump is racism. So if you're white and you vote for him, you are a racist. And if you are black and you vote for him, you're mentally ill. Now, when signs like this are displayed, the concern that I have is absolute statements are being made without any qualifiers whatsoever, without any rhyme or reason. It is the opinion of that church. Now, by the way, according to the law, the sign is illegal. According to the Johnson Amendment, provides that 501c3 organizations, charitable nonprofits, houses of worship, and foundations, in exchange for the privilege of receiving donations that are tax deductible to the donors, may not support or oppose candidates for elected offices. They cannot support or oppose candidates. This sign certainly does oppose President Trump. And it insinuates that black people who vote for the president are mentally ill. So my question, the thing that initially came to my mind, comes to mind, is apparently, is this church a church filled with psychiatrists and psychologists, people who work in the mental profession? And are they, have they interviewed? Have they personally treated? Have they talked to African-Americans who voted for the president? On what grounds do you say this? And are they experts on the issues of race? In that, have they sat down and talked to? Can they see in the heart of people who are white who vote for who voted for the president? Are they the final authority to make such a blanket statement? How do you qualify the statement? There are some people, African-American, who may have voted for the president. I don't know. They may support his position on life. They may believe that that Planned Parenthood, who slaughters at least 900 black babies per day in abortion, that is not a good thing. The tremendous March on Washington that Dr. King led, over 250,000 in attendance. Since Roe v. Wade, that many blacks have been aborted per year, each year, since 73. So maybe there are those who would vote for the president because they agree with his attempt to lessen abortions. He just took $60 million from Planned Parenthood. Oh, I hear and agree with those who oppose the president's tone, the language. No one can support that kind of bolster and tone and language. But on the other hand, to call someone mentally ill, is it mental illness to believe that if you like him because of what he's doing with prescription drug prices, they're going down? Is it mental illness if you agree with him on what he did for the historical black colleges and their debt or other things that have transpired with this president? I think my point is, if you're going to make an argument Number one, do it within the confines of the law. But come after us with the same study and the same learned intensity as you would any other group. Don't throw crazy things at black people. I remember one candidate was talking, speaking to a black audience, and they said, the Republicans, they're gonna put y'all back in chains, and our people cheered. Come on, that's an insult to the intelligence of African Americans. We're way beyond that. We're not gonna be put back in chains. Doesn't matter who the president is. There are so many things that you may disagree with a person. You may disagree with whom a person may vote for, but you shouldn't. This notion of shaming, that's what it is, the shaming that is taking place, that we're going to shame you or boycott you or put you out of position, put you out of business, or not visit your church or not work with you because your political views are different from mine. Is the whole point of a democratic republic, isn't the whole political process, isn't it about views and discussing the differences in views and having a peaceful exchange of power? One person is voted in, another person is voted out. The proof has already come in. There's no evidence at all that Russia actually changed one vote. President Obama even said the thought that the Russians could shape our, affect our elections is nonsense. And that the president, that candidate Trump should go out and get some more votes. They knew that Russia was trying to interfere with the election in 2014, and nothing was done about it. So there are things. I think that as African Americans, we should not be pigeonholed, that we should not be ostracized and criticized if we have a different point of view. And most certainly, our churches should not put signs up that would say to vote for one candidate means you're mentally ill if you're black, and to vote for that same candidate means you're racist if you're white. And surely New Era Baptist Church knows that a actual racist white person could care less about a sign that they display in front of their church. And a white person who is not racist, who may disagree with them politically, will take a dim view of the church if the church comes at them and paints them with a broad brush. I think that the fact that African Americans, our community, is the only community that votes 90% one way is not good for us. It says to the party that's going to get our vote no matter what, give black people no matter what, because they're going to vote for us anyway. It says to the party who won't get our vote no matter what, there's no point in doing anything for them no matter what, because we won't get their vote anyway. So I think that our votes, our positions should be up for grabs, just like all the rest of the communities. Nobody checks the Hispanic card, the Asian card, or any other group's card, identity card, based on how they vote. So my friends, I pray that New Era and other churches, if you disagree, disagree, but disagree within the confines of the law and make the argument. You're not settling anything just because you say that a group of people are mentally ill or racist. People may be, they may not be, but the whole point of an election, the whole point is for people to vote their convictions, vote for people whose policies are helping them. It could be that there are African Americans who are voting for the president because they agree with his position on Israel, that they celebrate that he did move the embassy to Jerusalem, declaring Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, or the other things that he has done. And there are African Americans who oppose the president and have reasons to disagree with the president. I don't think those who oppose President Trump are mentally ill, and I don't think that it's right to accuse those who do agree with the president where they agree with him on mental illness. I do wonder if we want to talk about things like that when it comes down to the issue of abortion. for instance, abortion is really the big killer of African Americans. And yet we vote 90% of the time for the politicians who are in favor of abortion on demand, abortion up to the time of birth, and some now are in favor of killing the baby after the baby has been born. And it disproportionately affects the African-American community. And yet there are African-American churches who will allow a politician to come up and stand in their church and say, I support a woman's right to choose, even though this thing, abortion, is disproportionately destroying us, and not to mention that the Bible speaks against the shedding of innocent blood. There are those African-Americans who support politicians who are in favor of same-sex marriage. Now, we know what the Bible says about same-sex marriage. It doesn't. It speaks against homosexuality. According to the scriptures, to qualify for marriage, you got to be male and female. The male marries the female marries the male. And yet, there are those who love Jesus Christ, who claim to love the Lord, claim to be Bible-caring, Bible-believing Christians, and yet they can find it in their heart to support candidates and to support a political party that has in its platform, a support for lifestyles in its platform that the Bible declares abominable, that has in its platform a support for abortion. And this is the murder, the killing of the unborn. So, but I wouldn't call them mentally ill. You see what I'm saying? If you choose to do that, you know, I don't see it, I can't see it, but if you do, that's your choice. But I'm not gonna put a sign up that declares that all who take such positions are mentally ill. The Charlottesville hoax. Now, Steve Cortez is no fan of President Trump. Steve Cortez, as a matter of fact, is a contributor to Real Clear Politics, and he is a CNN political commentator. Cortez admits that when President Trump made the statement that there are good people on both sides, that he was not saying that there are good Antifa and that there are good Klansmen, but he was talking about people on both sides of the issue, which had to do with whether or not the statue, the Robert E. Lee statue, should be removed. So the comment, if you go back and listen to the interview, clearly was about the issue and not the people who were engaged in the clash, which neither group are friends of black people. Antifa is not a friend of the black race. Neither is the Ku Klux Klan a friend of the black race. And yet the media has pushed this narrative to affect the thinking of people. So my friends, I'm saying to you, vote for who you want, but make an informed vote. A friend of mine asked me the other day, what is the political makeup of your church, Democrat or Republican? I said to him, I have no idea, for I've never asked that question. I never have, and I never will. As far as I'm concerned, it's irrelevant. But what I do is I encourage the members to study the issues, to go beyond the headlines, to do your homework, and then cast that informed vote. Either way you vote, that's between you and the Lord. But it ought to be an informed one, and it shouldn't be influenced by rhetoric such as New Era Baptist Church. I'm Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr., and I'll talk to you next time. God bless.